Hello friends, welcome to CyberCat Solutions. In this session, I am going to explain how to read Excel data and use it in AutoCAD to create objects through Autolisp program. So reading Excel file through Autolisp program is a bit difficult. We have to use VisualLisp ActiveX functions to read the Excel file. To do this simply, we have another option. We can save Excel file as CSV. Comma delimited format file. Let us say I have one Excel file, spot elevations, which is having coordinates of some points. So in this, A column contains X coordinate, B column contains Y, and C column contains Z coordinates of 6 points. So just save this file as CSV format file. So save as and change to comma delimited CSV format and click save. It is saying there are multiple sheets, no problem, save OK. And again say yes and close this Excel. You don't have to save it again. So here if you see spot elevations.csv file is there. It looks similar to Excel file. Just open that one and see what is there. The same data and it is being opened by Excel only. But if you try to open this with Notepad, it is a binary file where each cell value is separated by commas. You can see that one here in Notepad. So now it can be read very easily through Autolisp program by three functions. So let us see what are those three functions. The first one is open function, which is used to open a binary file through Autolisp program. And the second one is close function, which is used to close the open file, which is open for reading or writing. And the last one is read line, which is used to read line by line in the open file. So let us see one by one how to use these three functions in Autolisp. So go to VisualLisp IDE and take a new sheet and stretch them to corners. Now let us see how to use this open function. So open, file name and mode. This is the syntax of open function. So what is this file name? File name is nothing but file path and file name only. Mode. Coming to mode, there are three different modes. What are they? The first one is read mode. This, if you open a file with read mode, it will give you a link, that is file descriptor, through which we can read line by line. Okay. Or you can read up to the end also using other functions. And the second one is write. Write mode. If you open in write mode, you can write data into the open file. If there is no file with the specified name, then a file will be created with the given name and in that the data will be written. And if there is a file with the same name with the provided name, then all the data in that will be removed and the new data will be written on that existing file. Coming to the last one, append. This is to append the data to the existing file, means existing data will still be there. Again, the additional data will be appended at the end of that file. So we are going to see the first one, read mode. Okay. So how to write this statement? Open. So open file name. Let us say D colon backslash slash say test.txt. That is my file name. And the mode is read. Simply write R so that it means R for read, W for write, A for append. So this is how we write the open statement. Then coming to read line. Read line. So here we need to give file descriptor. What is this file descriptor? If you execute this statement, that will return one file link, means the open file link to the program that we need to provide over here. So that is what the file descriptor. And then close. Even close is similar to read line, close file descriptor. So what are the file descriptor returned by this open function? You need to provide the same over here to close that file once you finish reading or writing. Okay. So let us see how to use all these things in our program. Let us start to write a program. Okay. I'm removing all these things and our program is program to read Excel and place point objects in AutoCAD. But I just want to show you one thing. Open file name. Let us take the same file name. So here my path is this one. So this is the path and the two backslashes, and take the spot elevations. I just want to show you how to create the open statement and read the file individually. Here you need to put two backslashes in the file path, because single will be treated as different one. And then coming to the end, you need to put read mode. Okay, so that is how we write this open statement. Just select this statement and click load selection. Oh, one more thing, I just want to save this file descriptor into a variable, setqfid, that is my variable name into which I want to save this, because open will return one file descriptor. I am just saving it into fid variable. Select this statement and click load selection over here. You can see a file descriptor is created here. So now let us try to read one line over here. So read line fid. Okay, just load this and see what will be written. Click this one. You can see 5, 5, 5. That is the first line in that file. Hope you do remember just before we have opened that file. So like this, we will read line by line. If you repeat this one, it will go to the second line. Just click that one. You can see 6, 6, 6 is coming. So you need to execute it in a while loop so that you will keep on going line by line. And once it goes to end of the file, it will return null so that the loop will come out. So that is how we are going to read this data, that we'll see in the program. Okay, and we need to close that file for sure at the end. So close FID. So if you do not close this one, that file cannot be edited or removed. Just see this one. I am trying to delete this one, CSV file. So it will say it cannot delete that one. Why? We have not closed that one. Until you close and close this file, you cannot modify the file as well as you cannot delete the file. Okay, so you need to close that file. Okay, so that is the formal procedure. Okay, then now write our program. Program to read Excel and place point objects in AutoCAD. So I'm writing it like this: define C colon, say Excel points. Okay, that is my program. Close define and start like this. Here setq file descriptor, open statement, and here I am going to save this Excel into the same location where my spot elevations are there, so that we don't have to write the complete path. So reading Excel. Okay, then so simply write spot elevations.exe, that's it, so that the path will be finished, because the list file is also in the same path. That is why I am not mentioning the path of the file. And then read mode. So here we will get FID, but you need to ensure whether it is opened or not by putting a if before to that one. If the file is opened, then throw again and close. So in this we need to read line by line. So I am starting a while loop over here. Setq line data, read line from FID. So if this read line returns something, that will be saved in the variable line data, and that if that happens, the while loop will continue. Okay, then so we have seen already that what is it being returned, 5, 5, 5, which is sufficient to provide as input to the point command. Let us see what is it I am going to write. Command point. Once you enter the point command, what will the AutoCAD ask? It will ask for the coordinates of the point to place. So the same thing, line data we can directly provide as argument to this command and put a enter so that the command will complete. And again, once this is finished, it will go to loop once again and it will execute the same statement. If that is returned, once again another point object will be created. If the read line returns nothing, then while loop will get exited and we need to close our file over here. close FID. Okay, and I want to do one more thing. I want to change the point style over here, point display style. For that I am writing something like this: set var pd mode to 32, so that point objects will be clearly visible. Otherwise zero type will be there, which looks like a single dot. Sometimes they are not visible properly. And at the end, we know that just write a print over here. That's all. So just check this one. Go to tools, check the text in the editor. No errors found. And again, go to tools and load text into the editor. So this is loaded into AutoCAD. What is our command? Excel points. Okay, seems like bigger one. So simply write Excel PT, otherwise Excel. Okay, again, tools, check text in the editor. And tools, load text into the editor. Our command is Excel. Go to AutoCAD and type the Excel. Type Excel, enter. See, there are 6 points placed over here. Just type li list command and select the first one and check the coordinates 5, 5, 5. Similarly, the last one 10, 10, 10. So this is how to read the data from Excel and use it in AutoCAD, friends. Check the line data once again. It is null. Why? Because the last returned data by the read line is null. That is why this while loop has come out and the file has been closed and PD mode has been set. So what is it we are doing? Let us see the statements one by one. First, we are opening this spot elevations.csv through open function and reading the file descriptor into a variable called FID. Then we are reading line by line using function called readLine and storing it in line data variable, and we are just passing the data which is written by the read line to the command point. Okay, once the while loop finishes, we are closing the file and setting the point display mode to 32. That's all. Very simple program to read the Excel data. You can enhance it to any level. Okay friends, hope you understood how to read Excel data and use it in AutoList program. Okay, if you like this program, please subscribe to my channel and share this video to your friends. Thanks for watching and welcome to the next session. Friends, if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and share this video to your friends. Thanks for watching and welcome to the next session.